In this video, we will see what dictionaries are, how to create them, how to use them for different purposes, and how they compare to other data structures like sets and lists. Dictionaries, also known as associative arrays, hash tables, or maps in other languages, are one of the most useful and versatile data structures in Python. They allow us to store and access data using key-value pairs, which means we can use any immutable object as a key and any object as a value. Let's start with the basics. What is a dictionary? A dictionary is another collection of key-value pairs where each key is unique and associated with a value. To create a dictionary, we use curly braces and separate the key-value pairs by comma. The keys and values can be any Python object, but the keys must be immutable, which means they cannot be changed. For example, we can use strings, numbers, tuples, or Boolean as keys, but not lists or sets. For example, we can create a dictionary that maps names to edges, like this. To access the value of a key in a dictionary, we use square brackets on the key names. For example, to get the edge of Alice, we write edges, the name of the dictionary, followed by Alice, the key, between square brackets. This will return 25. If we try to access a key that does not exist in the dictionary, we will get a key error. For example, trying to get the edge of David will raise an exception because there is no key David in the dictionary. To add a new key value pair to a dictionary, we simply assign a value to a new key using the assignment operator. For example, adding David's edge to the dictionary. This will create a new entry in the dictionary with the key David and the value 21. We can also update the value of an existing key by assigning a new value to it, like changing Alice's edge to 26. This will replace the old value of 25 with the new value of 26. To delete a key value pair from the dictionary, we can use the del keyword or the pop method. The del keyword removes the key value pair from the dictionary without returning anything. The pop method removes the key value pair from the dictionary and returns the value of the removed key. Using the pop method with the argument Bob will return 32. And remove the entry with the key Bob from the dictionary. Dictionaries have many other methods that allow us to manipulate and access them in different ways. Some of the most frequently used methods are keys, which return a view object that contains all the keys in the dictionary. Values return a view object that contains all the values in the dictionary. Items return a view object that contains all the key value pair in the dictionary. Get returns a value of a given key or a default value if the key does not exist. The method can be used to get Alice's edge or 0 if she is not in the dictionary. In this particular example, the value 26 is returned. However, calling the method with the argument Lillian returns 0, as the key Lillian is not in the dictionary. SetDefault sets the value of a given key if it does not exist, or return its current value. Calling the method with the argument Eve on 19 sets Eve's edge to 19 if she is not in the dictionary, or get her current edge if she is. In our example, Eve will be set with the value 19. Update the dictionary with another dictionary or an iterable of key value pairs. For example, we could update our edges dictionary with another dictionary that contains more names like Frank and Grace. Clear removes all the key value pairs from the dictionary. Now that we understand the power of dictionary, let's explore how to traverse through them and access their key value pairs. There are a couple of approaches we can take, each with its own advantages and use case. One common way to traverse a dictionary is by using a for loop. In this approach, we iterate over the keys of the dictionary and access the corresponding value. At each iteration, the variable person is assigned a different key from the dictionary ages. We can then use the variable person to retrieve its associated value, which is then assigned to the variable age. Another approach is to use the items method of the dictionary. The method returns a sequence of tuples containing the key and its corresponding value. This can make the code clearer and more intuitive. Using a for loop is straightforward and works well when you only need to access the keys or perform operations solely based on the keys. It's also helpful when you want to modify the dictionary during traversal. On the other hand, the items method is great when you need to work with both keys and values simultaneously. It's concise and clearer, enhancing the readability of your code. Let's explore a more concise and efficient way to iterate through dictionaries using comprehensions. These are powerful tools that can help you achieve the same result as traditional loops, but with less code. Just like list comprehension, dictionary comprehension allows us to create dictionaries in a more compact and elegant manner. We can iterate through the keys and values of a dictionary, apply some operation, and create a new dictionary. In this example, we're using a dictionary comprehension to create a new dictionary called ages in month. We iterate through the ages using the items method. For each key value pair, we are transforming the value by multiplying it by 12. The resulting dictionary contains the same keys, but with the value in months rather than years. We can also incorporate conditions into dictionary comprehension. This allows us to filter and create dictionary based on a specific criteria. Here we're using a conditional dictionary comprehension to create a new dictionary called children. We iterate through ages and only include key value pairs where the value is smaller than 18. As a result, we get a dictionary containing only children. Dictionary comprehension offers several benefits. They are concise, making your code easier to read and maintain. They also often execute faster than traditional loops because they're optimized under the hood. It's important to note that dictionaries are unordered. So the order in which the key value pairs are traversed might not be the same as they were initially inserted. Traversing dictionaries is a fundamental skill every Python programmer should have. By understanding these different approaches, you will be equipped to navigate through your data effectively, choosing the approach that best suits your specific use case. Now that we know how to create and use dictionaries, let's see how they compare to other data structures like sets and lists. Sets are also an ordered collection of unique elements, but they do not have a key value pair. Lists are ordered collection of elements that can be accessed by index, but they can have duplicate elements. Dictionaries have some advantages and disadvantages over sets and lists, depending on the use case. One advantage of dictionaries is that they allow us to access data by name or meaning, rather than by position or order. This makes the code more readable and intuitive, and avoids error due to index out of range or wrong order. For example, if we want to store the grades of some student in a course, we can use a dictionary that maps students' names to grades, like this. To get the grade of Alice, we can simply write soft1 grades square bracket, and the key Alice between the square bracket. This will return 90. If we use a list instead, we have to remember the position of Alice in the list, which can be error-prone and hard to maintain. For example, we can instantiate the list grades equal 90, 85, 100, assuming Alice is at index 0, Bob is at index 1, and Lillian is at index 2. To get the grade of Alice, we have to write grades with 0 between square brackets. This will also return 90, but it is less clear and more fragile. Another advantage of dictionaries is that they are very fast for finding elements by key. This is because, like set, dictionaries use a technique called hashing, which maps each key to a unique number that determines its position in the dictionary. This allows us to access any element in constant time, regardless of the size of the dictionary. For example, if we have a dictionary with a million entries, we can still find any element in one step. If we use a list instead, we have to search through the whole list until we find the element we want, which can take a lot of time if the list is large. For example, if we have a list of a million elements, we may have to check up to a million elements before we find the one we want. One disadvantage of dictionary is that they are not ordered. This means that we cannot rely on the order of the element in the dictionary, as it may change depending on how the dictionary is implemented and how the keys are hashed. This also means that we cannot sort a dictionary by its keys or values, as sorting requires an order. If we need to preserve or impose an order on our data, we may have to use a list instead. For example, if we want to store the names and ages of some people in alphabetical order by name, we may have to use a list of tuples, like this. To get the first person in the list, we can write people 0. This will return Alice 25. If we use a dictionary instead, we cannot guarantee that Alice will be the first element in the dictionary, as the order may change. Another disadvantage of dictionary is that they take more space than sets or lists. This is because dictionaries store both keys and values for each element, which requires more memory than storing only elements. This also means that dictionaries are more complex and require more operations than sets or lists. If we only need to store unique elements without any associated data or meaning, we should use a set instead. I have been saying from the start that dictionaries are unordered. However, as of Python 3.7, dictionaries are insertion ordered, meaning that when traversing the dictionary, the pairs will be traversed in the order they were inserted. Note that updating a key does not affect the order. Keys added after deletion are inserted at the end. In other words, you must be aware of the environment you are working with. If you need to preserve backward compatibility with older versions of the language, you must consider dictionaries as unordered. In summary, dictionaries are powerful and flexible data structures that allow us to store and access data using key-value pairs rather than indices. They have some advantages and disadvantages over other data structures like sets and lists, depending on the use case. Dictionaries are great for accessing data by name or meaning, rather than by position or order. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.